I believe contrast is one of the best concepts that you can start incorporating with your outfits. It's a little tiny thing that I think about a lot whenever I come up with fits. Sounds very technical, but it's not that serious, and here's why you should consider it next time you put a fit together. So what is the definition of contrast? Well, Google says the state of being strikingly different from something else in juxtaposition or close association. Basically, a comparison between two things. White and black, Chinese food and American food, streetwear and menswear, city life, suburban life, you guys get it. Now, when it comes to fashion, this is especially important because this is where you get to add your own uniqueness to any of your fits. Yeah, I enjoy an all-fitted look. I enjoy a more relaxed fitting approach as well. Those looks, they do look great, but you can also take it too far, and then you'll look a little bit off. What I always recommend when starting off is an oversized shirt and skinny or slim pants. It always works and is a lot more different than Mr. Sausage Man over here. I'm sure a lot of you guys have been doing this. It's been something that's been done for a while now, but what I don't see enough of is a more slim fitted top with more relaxed fitting pants. Seems like a lot of people stray away from this, and I get it. It can be a little bit awkward, but trust me guys, if you do this right, it can actually look really good and it'll actually make you stand out because not that many people do it. I always like a fitted shirt or an athletic tank with my ACG Deploy cargos. A good spring summer tech fit for sure that looks good, especially if you do lift, which is what I would encourage you guys to do if you guys do go down that fitted top with more relaxed fitting pants route. I do have a home workout video if you guys are interested in that. It's what I do if I don't have a gym, perfect for the situation we're in right now. And another thing you can start incorporating are jackets. Oversized jackets can be a bit overwhelming, I understand that, but you'll develop the courage over time. Just start off cheap. When starting off, I do recommend starting off with an oversized coat, a denim jacket, or a bomber. These pieces will dramatically change your silhouettes, but just be aware that it's going to change the professionality of your fit. So it's probably not gonna work in the professional realm, so I don't recommend doing that. Now let's translate that to different fashion styles. Take this Mandarin collar button up, for example. Normally, you would associate with some sort of smart, hipster, sophisticated type of look, right? That's what I would usually think about, and those fits look great as well. We're bringing two different types of motifs together, like a fusion restaurant, makes your fit all the more creative and distinctive. I really enjoy styling this button up in a more technical look. Think of smart tech. The last item you'd expect to go well with the button up is these Mountain Fly Gore-Tex kicks. But in my opinion, the fit is pretty solid. Yeah, I could have just gone the crop trousers, glasses, and a ton of jewelry route with this look, and that would look great. But I want you to think of it like Xun La Tong, aka hot and sour soup. You get a ton of contrasting flavors. Spicy, sour, savory, and that's what makes it so addicting. If the soup was all spice or all sour, then it wouldn't be very interesting. You probably wouldn't be ordering it every time you go to a Chinese restaurant. So the next time you put together a fit, consider putting two different garments in juxtaposition with one another and just see if it works. It doesn't hurt to try and you might come up with something dope. Now let's talk about the contrast in color or lack thereof for this. Black and white, yin and yang. Y'all see that new Toyota Camry with the contrasting rooftop? That is a dope car, not gonna lie, and it's a Camry. This is something Toyota has been doing for the past few years. Mad respect for the CEO because he doesn't want to make boring cars anymore. And to me, this two-tier contrast is what makes the Toyota Camry visually interesting. And you can do the same with your fits. Sure, I love all black. I have a whole video on spicing up your all black fits, but let's face it, you need some contrast in your life. Now, if you're gonna do this, you gotta be careful. White and black is the definition of complete opposites, so it can be really harsh if you take it too far. So as a tip, I recommend having a good ratio of black and white. I'm not really about all white fits. I don't own any white pants whatsoever. So I always just tend to wear a white shirt or a white top, and I always try to compensate for that harsh contrast by just wearing more black. Check this summer fit I wore last year. I've got on a white oversized top. Takes up most of the real estate on my body, because I was wearing shorts, black shorts by the way. So to compensate, I wore black crew socks and a black dad hat, and the sneakers were also white, but they did have a little bit of black contrasting details, and I felt that it worked. Don't get me wrong, you don't need to do this. This is just what I personally do because I don't like wearing all white, but you do whatever you want. So since I'm filming this in winter, I tend to wear all black except the white shirts or white sneakers, and that's always a go-to look. With this type of contrasting colors, you can focus on just the silhouettes and letting those speak for themselves. Another thing you can do is play off your materials and fabrics. Instead of a cotton top, maybe try on a corduroy or a knitted top. You can get a distinct contrast in patterns or fabric texture that just overall makes your fits have some more depth. I like to think of this like a bowl of pho. And alright, I get it, some people don't like bean sprouts or basil or any of that, but to me, that's what makes a bowl of pho a bowl of pho. Otherwise, it's just noodles and beef in a broth. There's not very much texture variation, but throwing in the lime will contrast against the fatty broth, and the veggies add a textural crunch whenever you take a bite. And if you don't like pho, sorry, I don't think I can trust you. But anyways, think of those toppings like jewelry, accessories, different fabrics or materials, like nylon, denim, sherpa, metal, glass, etc. I think you guys get the points on what I'm trying to articulate. If I'm wearing a black top and black bottoms, I always choose to add a keychain or a nylon belt to help break up the silhouettes, because that little bit of textural detail is all that's needed. I also enjoy just wearing a corduroy hoodie underneath a jacket instead of a normal French terry one. I'm not gonna do it every time, but it's a great way to modify your normal fits. But jewelry is the name of the game. A watch typically is made out of stainless steel and sapphire glass, and it's another way to add some visual flair to your outfit. I just picked up this Casio G-Shock square watch, which has a silicone strap and stainless steel and glass. Looks pretty dope. So just find an accessory that you gravitate towards. For me, it's always a necklace, a watch, and all that. But believe it or not, guys, you guys have been doing this, and I applaud you. Jordans, they are basketball sneakers, but does that mean I can't wear it off the court? Of course not. Same with skate sneakers. Can I only wear them in a skate fit? Of course not. Contrast is what gives people a better appreciation for said item or anything. For example, whenever I first hit up New York City, and I know I talked about this in another video, but I am from Albuquerque, New Mexico, Breaking Bad territory.
You're goddamn right.
It's a more suburban, small city life. And with New York, I had never experienced people going to the park just to hang out and people watch. Normally, it was just to play ball or to walk my dog. Nor did I experience businesses opened up past 9 o'clock. But also, I had never experienced a musty, humid, loud, hey, I'm walking over here type of energy, which was overwhelming for me at first, and I got used to it. But it gave me a new appreciation for the New Mexican dry heat, a little bit of peace and quiet, and green chili. And this is gonna happen to you too. Try rocking a sneaker or jewelry you wouldn't normally do. Try out a different aesthetic that you normally wouldn't. This is kind of like the first point, but with a different analogy. I've always seen people just hate on an aesthetic when they've never really tried it out, which is my whole point about contrast. When you try something new, it's a direct contrast to what you're used to, and then you'll build a new appreciation for it, even if you don't like it. So I hope you guys get what I'm trying to say there. This is why you need contrast with your outfits. Think about how you can contrast your fits next time you hit up the wardrobe, and also think about checking out Rose Gold and Black, who I will now take a moment to thank for sponsoring this video. So Rose Gold and Black is the best place to start off. I always recommend it if you are new to jewelry, because no matter your preference, they always have something that you'll probably like. They have beaded bracelets, rings, watches, all the way to sterling silver Cuban chains. Personally, I dig all their minimal designs, like this minimal bar necklace right here. I also have their sterling silver Odyssey necklace, which is pretty dope. Its simple, sleek, and clean design is what makes it so versatile. I can rock it with pretty much any fit, and it'll always complement it. This minimal bar necklace is one of my favorites. I wear it all the time. They have a ton of different colors as well for your preference. Like this one's a gunmetal black. They have an all black one, a silver, and a rose gold one, obviously. So definitely check out the link in the description. It's going to take you guys to my special landing page, where a ton of items are going to be heavily discounted. They are currently still doing their holiday sale, so everything's going to be 25% off. And if you enter the code VIBE15, you're gonna get an additional 15% off. So go ahead and treat yourself. I always recommend their minimal bar necklaces, but most of their stuff is pretty minimal anyways. Thank you guys for always supporting the sponsors, and thank you Rose Gold and Black for sponsoring today's video. So I hope you guys found this video insightful. Give this video a thumbs up, follow me on Instagram at FlyWithJohnnyTie, and subscribe.